This is a frame, wooden frame and wooden base, and this is nylon thread. Two hooks are there, one pendulum, other pendulum. The lengths are not equal, one is long, one is short comparatively, and if I energize one pendulum, we can observe that when this pendulum keeps on oscillating, you can observe motion of this pendulum. We observe that the amplitude of this pendulum goes on increasing and then it goes on decreasing and stops. You can observe, see this. Stop. Again start. See the amplitude of this will increase. Yes, it is increasing now. And now it will decrease and it will stop. And this keeps on repeating for several times. And this happens because the length of this and length of this are different. They don't have any resonance. But now if I change the pendulum and make the two pendulums of equal length, I will observe a phenomenon of resonance. Now I am going to energize this pendulum and you observe that this pendulum is oscillating and now this also has started oscillating. Amplitude of this is increasing and amplitude of this is decreasing because this pendulum will transfer some energy to the other pendulum via this thread. And we observe here that the amplitude of first is now decreasing while amplitude of second is now increasing. Now second is going to maxima while first is coming to minima, and if the two threads are perfectly equal length matching, then this will stop completely and this will go to maxima. But after going to maxima, it will return the energy back to the first pendulum. So now you observe that this second pendulum is having decreasing amplitude while the first one is having increasing amplitude. And you observe very carefully that now second pendulum is losing the energy and first is gaining the energy. Now the second one is on the verge of stopping. Yes, 1, 2, 3, stop. It has stopped, totally stopped. And now again, it will start picking up the energy from other pendulum because there is reverse transfer of energy. And here we observe that the second has started oscillating with more and more amplitude while the first one is losing energy. If you observe for a few more oscillations, you will find that the first pendulum will come to stop and second will go to maxima. This is happening because of resonance. In resonance, the energy transfer from source to receiver and from receiver back to source is 100%. It is a resonance phenomenon. So we observe that the two pendulums are having the exchange of energy and they are the coupled oscillators. They are the coupled oscillators. Here we can have another modification. If the two pendulums are unequal, we get very poor transfer of energy. Now I am making three pendulums, and very interesting case is that out of these three, two are equal length and one is short. Now if I make both these pendulums energized and leave it, you can observe very funny thing here that these two are oscillating with same period, same frequency and almost same amplitude, and the third one is picking up the energy. It goes to maxima, now it has stopped. You see, now it is moving. Now the middle one is moving, its amplitude is now maximum and now it is decreasing, and you can see it will stop now. Yes, stop. See, the middle has stopped. We can observe that the middle pendulum will pick up and return the energy to the other two pendulums. This is a case of one receiver and two sources. But if we make it reverse, I make one source and two receivers. See what happens. I make one source and two receivers. Now I observe that the source is supplying the energy to the two receivers, and the two receivers are in the same phase. The two receivers are in the same phase. Now you observe the both receivers have stopped. Now it is again starting. They are again starting to oscillate. Now their amplitude is going to maximum. Now we have maximum of the amplitude, and now reverse exchange is there. Now the two are losing the energy and both have stopped, almost stopped. So we can see that there is transfer and back transfer of energy from one source to the two receivers. But if I make the two sources and one receiver, and if the two are in same phase, I can observe the energy transfer. But I will make a change now. I will make one backward and one forward, and both start at the same time. In this case, both are oscillating, but the middle one is not moving at all because it is not getting any energy. Now, why it is not getting energy? Because this pendulum and this pendulum, they are oscillating out of phase, and if they are providing disturbance out of phase, they are totally zero. The simple idea is that if the two pendulums are having out of phase movement, they transfer the energy in opposite phases, then the total energy received by the central one is zero. We can prove this mathematically. Suppose disturbance received by the central one is, say, y1 is equal to a sin omega t and y2 is equal to minus a sin omega t. Then superposition principle, y1 plus y2 is equal to zero, because a sin omega t and minus a sin omega t is zero. And that means that the middle pendulum will have zero displacement for all time t, and that is why it is not moving at all. This is called as out of phase or 180 degree phase difference, and that is why we have this very special case. Thank you.